the ultimate electric motorcycle with unseen specs packed with breakthrough technology. It's capable of 27 kilowatt power, makes from 0 to 100 in 6 seconds, charges in 60 minutes, and it can easily make 80 kilometers per charge. Built-in 3 kilowatt charger is the very peak of user experience and makes CyberBike one of a kind worldwide. Its maximum speed is 116 kilometers an hour, and this amount of torque is completely addictive. And now it's cheaper than ever before. These cells are the core of our power. 44 of these combined build this beautiful art-like battery pack with Bluetooth BMS built in-house. This innocent looking piece of hardware is the motor and is capable of pulling 27 kilowatt peak. That is enough for skidding, wheelies, drifting, and beautifully manages heat. On the second generation of CyberBike, we upgraded these essential components like a suspension. Now this is a heavy duty proper motorcycle suspension with motorcycle brakes for equal amount of brake power. The battery fits nicely inside of the frame and is protected with this aluminum case that protects it from mechanics and holds the battery in. Motor is mounted as a mid-drive that gives us the unique opportunity to change the power ratio with the rear sprocket. If you want more speed, you got it. If you want more torque, we mount the big sprocket. Wheels can be different, depends on what you want. Obviously, smaller wheel will be more aggressive. And if you're a taller guy and you want a bigger bike, you just replace it with the bigger wheels. The built-in charger is below the frame, behind this cover, and it sucks air through the frame so no dust gets in there and exhausts the hot air from down below. Everything is fully customizable, meaning different lever brakes, different rotors, and all these panels. This is all 3D printed, different filaments can be used, completely limitless spectrum of color options. I'm having my creative time with all of the other bikes, which I can play with. Frame colors, 3D print colors, rim colors, and I always have few following color options I want to make. I'm still blown away with all the 3D prints. I designed them all myself, prototyped them, and they work like a charm and make this modular system, meaning I can replace them any day if I want. And the coolest thing is that we mount the controller below the seat so it can cool down. All the wires go through the frame behind all these panels, straight in here where you have easy access. You can clip it and unclip. Here's a breaker, and everything is just neatly waterproof, hidden in there. Bang. Would you believe all these parts are 3D printed? Created from scratch, created from a software. That means just a thought. This is a physical thought. And it's printed on one of these small 3D prints as a two parts that create rear mudguard for cyber bikes. We epoxy them together. That makes it even stronger, the joint. They protect the spring, they protect the motor, and they look really, really sick on the bike. With time, I found these limitations of a printable size objects, and I started innovating how you can create these bigger sizes and bigger shapes. So this is my top piece that is a cover for the charger from the bottom of the bike. That is pretty large piece, look at this. It's a huge print. And I decided to print them on a three different printers at the same time. They print height like this, so it stands. And then I created these holes, so you just bolt them together, put some glue over this joint, and they seal it nicely. And you just see a tiny joint. And the benefit of 3D printing is that I have full control over these details. Like I can create a holes to drain some potential water from the cover, and also nicely shaped grids to take all the hot air from the charger, and on the other hand, not to spray any mud in there from the rear wheel. That's just mind-blowing. These light mounts are 3D printed clamps that tie around the handlebar, make it super stiff and sturdy, and then you end up with nicely adjustable front light. This is tail light that took me at least 12 tries to do it in this final stage. It prints with no supports. It's a really small, sleek design, looks great. It's plug and play at the moment. And then it also has a brake light. And at night, it does look really cool. Another print I'm really proud of is this door. The 3D printer door with a hinge itself. Look at that, it's made out of two pieces, they just slide together on a joint, and then these hinges just slide in with no glue needed, and they have a nice little foot to glue them inside of the frame. And I'm also printing parts that hold magnets inside of the frame, they are held on a glue, and the door nicely closes. Never happens that it would open when riding, and it just works like a charm. This is called controller. This is just a display that shows you all the information you need to know, like current voltage, speed, amps you're drawing from the battery, shows you how much battery you have left, it shows you motor temperature, controller temperature, and a power mode. You change them here. I personally like setting reverse here that I use very often, then kind of a slower power mode, and then full on power mode. You have full control, you can set whatever functions you have on these buttons. Throttle is like on any other motorcycle, and then you have this cool feature of this bike that's a regen. That's a regenerative brake that uses the motor to create electricity, brake the bike, and charge the battery back. All these brakes have sensors, so they deactivate the throttle as a safety feature. And this bloody thing can seriously allow you to tweak everything for all of you nerds out there, even the color of these buttons. These lightweight motorcycle brakes stop the bike instantly, and they're especially needed for emergency braking. Regenerative braking, on the other hand, is non-friction braking that we use primarily because it uses stopping power to charge back to the battery. The bike is easy to maneuver, it's playful and forgiving. I am pleased with the second generation of suspension and bigger rims. Both the front fork and the rear shock are very well balanced for this amount of weight, and it's been the biggest improvement together with the brakes. Let's look at instant torque. I'm just twisting the throttle and transferring the power straight to the rear wheel. It immediately loses traction with the road. From the left to the right we go. It's time to leave you behind. Bye. If you're an e-bike rider, you're already familiar with this. If you're not, listen carefully, because charging is a huge part of using your electric bike. And be ready, this is what you're getting into. This is the most common, cheap and slow China charger that you usually get with your bike. It's a huge brick and it charges like 6 hours. So if you go for a trip, you carry that in your backpack and you need to wait a long time to charge it. That means it gives you essentially only one use a day. Then we sometimes have these chargers that are completely stupid heavy. It's such a big brick, it takes most of your space in a backpack when you're doing a trip, and it charges a little bit faster. It charges in with 12 amps, so let's say 3 hours, but still this is so inconvenient. The fastest charger we do is this combination that is so impractical. Look at that. look at these wires. It always gets clustered in your backpack. It charges fast. You can charge the bike in an hour and a half. That means you can usually take a break, charge it, and keep using it. That means you can discharge 3 times a day if you want. This is your reality of charging when you have an electric bike. You always end up with a brick. And that's why I need to stress and appreciate how sick it is that you don't deal with anything. Doesn't matter where you are, you just open the 3D printed door, plug it in, and charge with 3 kilowatts. That's like two of these fastest ones we have combined together, built into that frame. That means the whole bike, when it's fully discharged, charges in 1 single hour. And then it has a magnet here that clips and beautifully always closes itself, and nobody ever suspects there is a charger or there is even compartment unit behind where you can hide your wallet and whatever you need. The cheapest possible way how you can get one of the cyber bikes is just to build one yourself. I thought about it when I was building this and I put together all this essential information you need to have. That means parts list, buying all of these parts straight from the supplier and saving money. Then 2.5 hours long video guide guiding you step by step on point what to do. This bolt goes there, this goes there. Be aware of this, that's a common mistake. And then also, if you have a 3D printer, you can print all the parts yourself. If you don't feel comfortable, we can ship you finished battery, finished wheel with tires. So it ends up being just an adult Lego for you. Just the bolts and bolts together. Just the bolts there, red wire, green wire, black wire, all combined. If you live in Europe or UK and you're willing to spend some extra money for a finished product, we do run small production so we can help you out. It is a really fun, rewarding project that's gonna blow your mind and everybody around you. It's cool that Friday evenings you can be having a beer and putting together something this high tech that I've never seen even commercially produced. We had absolute blast and I purposely designed this whole system to be user-friendly and be for DIY people, so you guys have fun, you guys know it's easy and neat job following the video guide, and you really enjoy and don't problem solve at all. Whatever you sort out as a builder, it's always good to share it with me and a community so we can build on the top of each other's back, so we can be much stronger as a community than as individuals. We've built a fair amount of these bikes and they hold up really well. We haven't had a single problem reported by our customers, and I think we builders are the ones stressing them the most. It's completely maintenance free. On these mid-drive bikes, it's only important to keep the chain tight, maybe once a season replace brake pads, and that's it. Just charging and riding. No oil changes, no noise, and no pollution. For anyone who loves tweaking the performance, good news for you. Nuclear Controller offers the whole spectrum of options like changing the charging current or responsiveness of the throttle and brakes. We all started on small pedal assist bikes, and that's why I have to stop for a moment to appreciate the technological boom we are experiencing. I can't wait to see people riding cyber bikes all over the world.